What is time? Look at your hands. For a moment, just look. See the lines on your skin, the subtle shift of light. In this very second, as you watch, trillions of cells in your body are dying and being reborn. The light from your screen has traveled a vast distance to reach your eyes, a journey that itself took time. We are all trapped in it. We measure it, we chase it, we waste it, we mourn its passage. We say it flies, it heals, it's money. But what is it? Really? This isn't just a question for physicists in lab coats. This is the single most intimate and mysterious force shaping our existence. From the moment our hearts first beat to the final whisper of a thought, we are time. And yet, if you try to grab hold of it, it slips through your fingers like starlight. So, let's embark on a journey. Let's leave behind our clocks and calendars and dive into the great, shimmering, mystical mystery of time itself. For most of human history, we've thought of time as a river, a relentless, one-way flow from the source, the past, through the narrow canyon of the present, and out into the vast, unknown ocean of the future. The past is fixed, solid, a mountain of memories. The future is fluid, unwritten, a realm of possibilities. This feels true, doesn't it? It's baked into our language, our stories, our very bones. We even gave this idea a scientific-sounding name, the arrow of time. It always points forward. We remember yesterday, but we can't remember tomorrow. An egg can splatter on the floor, but the splattered mess on the floor will never spontaneously reassemble itself into a perfect whole egg. This seems like a fundamental rule of the universe. But why? Why does the arrow only fly one way? This is where the magic begins. Physicists tell us that the fundamental laws of the universe, the ones that govern how atoms dance and gravity pulls, don't actually care about this arrow. They work just as well backwards as they do forwards. If you were to watch a film of two planets orbiting each other, you wouldn't be able to tell if it was playing forwards or backwards. The dance is symmetrical. So, where does our one-way river come from? The secret might not be in the laws themselves, but in the arrangement of the universe. Think of it like a deck of cards. A brand new deck, perfectly ordered, is a very special, low-probability state. Shuffle it once, and it becomes disordered. Shuffle it a million times, and it will almost never return to that perfect, ordered state. The universe, at its very beginning in the Big Bang, was in an incredibly ordered, low-entropy state, like that pristine deck of cards. And ever since, it's been shuffling itself. The arrow of time is just the universe becoming more and more disordered, more random. It's the cosmic shuffling of the deck. Our perception of past and future is just us, tiny, conscious beings, riding this wave of increasing chaos from a state of incredible order. But that's just the what. It doesn't explain the feel. It doesn't explain why we feel the flow. Now let's shift our perspective entirely. What if the river is an illusion? What if the past, present, and future all exist simultaneously? This isn't just a psychedelic fantasy. It's a direct implication of Einstein's theory of relativity. He showed us that space and time are woven together into a single, four-dimensional fabric, space-time. In this grand cosmic tapestry, every event, your birth, the fall of the Roman Empire, the death of a distant star, has its own coordinates. It's here and it's when. From a God's eye view, outside the tapestry, all these events are just there, fixed, eternal. The universe is a single frozen block. This is called the block universe theory. In this view, the feeling of a moving present is just an illusion of our consciousness, a flickering candle moving along the world line of our lives, illuminating one slice of the block at a time. Think of a movie on a DVD. The entire film is there, from beginning to end, all at once. But when you play it, the laser in the DVD player only focuses on one frame at a time. That frame is your now. Your consciousness is the laser. This is a staggering, almost terrifying thought. It means that all the moments of your life, your first kiss, your last breath, are already out there, eternal and unchanging. You are just experiencing them in a linear sequence. So, which is it? A flowing river or a frozen block? Science offers us both, a beautiful and profound paradox. But the human soul has always sought a third, more magical answer. Perhaps time doesn't exist out there at all. Perhaps we create it. Your brain is not a passive recorder of time, it's an active generator of it. It takes a chaotic, constant storm of sensory input and weaves it into a coherent story. It stitches together a sequence of nows to create the narrative of your life. Think about how time feels when you're terrified, a car accident seeming to happen in slow motion, or when you're blissfully happy, a weekend that flashes by in an instant. This is your brain's time creation engine at work, modulating its rhythm based on emotion, focus, and novelty. But let's go deeper, into the realm of the mystical. Ancient traditions from the East have always spoken of time, Maya, as the great illusion. They propose that the ultimate reality is timeless, eternal, that our journey through life is the journey of a single, universal consciousness, fragmenting itself into billions of points of view, all for the experience of learning, feeling, and growing. In this view, you are not a drop of water flowing in the river of time. You are the river, and you are also the source and the ocean. You have chosen to forget your timeless nature to fully immerse yourself in this grand holographic play of separation and sequence. Time is the stage upon which the drama of consciousness unfolds. This is why déjà vu feels so mystical. It's a fleeting crack in the illusion, a moment where you glimpse the entire script of the play you're in. Precognitive dreams, synchronicities, these aren't breaks in the laws of physics, but gentle reminders that the linear sequence is a convenient, but not absolute, truth. We are dreaming ourselves into existence, moment by moment. If our present understanding is already this strange, what does the future hold? How will our relationship with time evolve? Imagine a future where we don't just measure time, but manipulate our perception of it. Neurotechnologies could allow us to dial into a state of deep time, where a single minute of subjective experience contains the richness of an hour. You could savor a coffee for what feels like a whole morning, or compress a long journey into a brief meditation. We might develop technologies that let us access the block universe not just as a theory, but as the experience. Not as time travel in the physical sense, but as conscious exploration. You could tune your consciousness to witness the Battle of Waterloo as a silent, non-interactive observer, just as you might rewind a film. The past would become a library of events, accessible to anyone with the right mental or technological key. And what of our individual timelines? The mystical idea of parallel lives, of a multiverse where every choice branches into a new reality, becomes a scientific possibility in theories like the many worlds interpretation. In this cosmic vision, you are not a single thread, but a tapestry. The version of you that took that job offer and the version that didn't both exist. The you that is watching this video and the you that clicked away are both real in their own respective universes. Time isn't a line, it's a fractal, an infinitely branching, blossoming tree of possibilities. And your consciousness is the strange attractor that gives coherence to one single, beautiful branch. So, what is time? It is the shuffling of the cosmic deck. It is the fourth dimension in a frozen block of reality. It is a story woven by your mind. It is the great illusion of a single, dreaming consciousness. It is a fractal tree of infinite possibilities. It is all of these things and none of them. It is the universe's way of making sure that everything doesn't happen all at once. And it is also the proof that, in a way, everything already has. We are temporary and eternal, all at once. We are the dream and the dreamer. This journey doesn't have to end here. If this conversation sparked something in you, if it made you look at the clock on your wall with a new sense of wonder, then do me a favor. Like this video and subscribe to the channel. It truly helps us to keep exploring these deep mysteries together. And I want to hear from you. This is a conversation. What does time feel like to you? Have you ever had an experience that shattered your linear perception of it? A dream? A synchronicity? A moment where time stood still? Comment down below and share your story. Let's build a community of time explorers. And for those of you who want to dive even deeper, to explore the idea that our reality is a cosmic hologram and that time is its most complex code, I've written a book that expands on all of this. It's called Holographic Multiverse. In it, we connect these dots between physics, consciousness, and the nature of reality itself. If you're intrigued, the link to check it out is in the description below. Thank you for spending this most precious resource, your time, with me today. Remember, the future is not a place you are going, but a reality you are creating right now. Until next time, stay curious.